A feature in Excel that is great is using tables instead of a range. Let's dive into this right now. I am Chris Menard. So in this worksheet that we're currently working on, this is a range. In case you're wondering, how do you know that it's a range and not a table? Well, when you look at the tabs at the top, home, insert, draw, I do not see a tab called table design. Table design is a contextual tab, and it shows up when you have a table. So to create your table, just click inside your data. You can go to insert. Here is table. You can use the keyboard shortcut Control T is what I love. I'm going to do that, Control T. It's asking you, is this your range and do you have a header row? I do have a header row, row one, so click on OK. And now we have table design up top. Here it is. So now this is a table. One easy feature about table is right here is table styles. If you hit the arrow for more, feel free just to mouse over the different styles. I'm going to go down here into the medium one. I'm going to go ahead and pick the second one right here just to select one. And there is my table style. I'm still using the table design tab. Other cool features is it's telling me that I have banded rows turned on. I'm going to uncheck that. I've just turned them off. Back on, off again. If you don't like the rows, this is kind of cool. You can go with banded columns. I recommend you don't do both. That just looks horrible. I'm going to just stay with the banded rows. Makes this really simple to read. Also, you can turn on what's called a total row. My data stops down in row 36, so when I select total row, there it is at the bottom in row 37. It'll always total up or do a function on the very last column. My last column is household type, so it counted the household type since it was text. But if I want to total up the purchases for 2022 or 2023, I'm going to move those over just a tad. Let's widen these just a little bit. There you go. If I want to total up 2023 column I, come and click down here at the bottom, hit the arrow, and look, there are your functions, none, average count, but I want to do a sum, 36,680 right there. You can continue to do totals for different columns. Back to table design at the top, and I'm going to turn off the total row. I encourage you to name your tables. I've been in here playing, so this become table two. If I made another table, it'd be table three. I like to name my tables TBL, and then what is this data? This is employees, so I'm going to do EMP. You can't have any spaces in the table name. Press enter, and now my table is called TBL EMP, table employees, how I know it. Because I usually have multiple tables throughout one Excel file, and I like to know what they are immediately. Table 2, table 3 are not good names. Another cool feature about a table is my header row is row 1. It is no longer a range. If it was a range, I would have to click row 2 and freeze the panes to always see the header row. Whenever you have a table and you start scrolling, your header row automatically freezes, if you notice that. Look right above row 13 on my screen, you'll see state, city, customer, all that information right there. So there is that right there. Cool, cool feature about tables is you have something called a calculated column. I want to take the purchases for 2023 and subtract 2022 to find out what is the difference. So I can do this anywhere I want to. Let me move this text box out of the way. I'm probably going to leave it. I'm going to insert a column at column J. It picked up purchases for 2024. Pretty smart. I'm just going to call it difference, D-I-F-F. I'm going to abbreviate. Equal. Grab the mouse. Click on that 3070. Also, tables will name the cell internally. Minus. Click on the 3000 and H2. And here's your calculated column. When you press enter, it'll automatically fill it down this column. That is a calculated column in column J right there. and it is showing you the names of what you selected right there. Very cool feature, calculated columns and naming. I'm not doing a pivot table now, but one cool feature about tables is when you create a pivot table from your table, and then you go and add records down below, your pivot table will know to include those when you refresh the pivot table. When it's a range, you got to go and change the range yourself, and that gets tedious, and you may even forget to do it. And I've already told you, name your tables. Let's keep moving over to the next worksheet and keep working on this. Go to the autos worksheet. Here we go again. It doesn't say table design, so it's not a table. Control T. Click OK. We've got a table. I am going to use a slightly different style here. I'm going to go with this orange one, the third medium. Whichever one you pick is okay with me. Let's run that calculated column again. When I did it the first time, I added it inside of the table. So this is so cool. I have invoice amount in column E. I've got cost next to it. Well, if I take the cost and subtract it from the invoice amount, let's make that the profit. Here we go again, equal the invoice amount minus the cost. Press enter. There's your calculated column. But what's cool is we added it to the table and it automatically picked it up. The same way if we added a row at the bottom, it would continue with this pattern it's doing right here. Also with the table, I didn't mention earlier, you get automatically filters so you can filter and sort. If I only want to see Honda as an example, I can hit the drop down for brand, take the check mark out of select all, select Honda and click OK. And the total number of my results is in the bottom left corner, 100 of 1,026. Hit that drop down and I'm going to clear that, but I could also sit here and sort from my filter arrows. Also with tables, and you can't do this with a range, I'm still in table design, you have something called slicers. I love slicers. So instead of using the filter arrows for brand and for rep and for dealership as an example, if I turn on insert slicer, it picked up my header row. I'm going to check brand, dealership, and rep. Click OK. Now I have what is called slicer sitting on my screen. You can move these around and resize them. So dealership, I may pull that one up since I only have three dealerships. I'm going to click in rep and pull that up a little bit. And the brand, so here's the issue. We've got a lot of different car brands. I could obviously widen this, but I've got the brand slicer selected. So now the contextual tab slicer appears, and I'm going to just make this three columns and pull this out. There you go. So now, instead of having to click the drop-down arrows to filter my data, I just want to see, as an example, Honda. I'm back to the same results I saw before. But what's nice about this is I know exactly what I picked. I'm also going to pick the dealership ABC dealership, and I want to pick myself as the rep, which would be Chris Menard. And there are my results. I can clear it right here, clear the rep, clear the dealership. Cool tip about the brand, if you want to select multiple brands, you can hold down the control key. So now I held down control, I selected two other brands, I've got three selected. You can also, if you want to, right now I've got just GM, I clicked it. You can also come here and say, I just want to select multiple. Now you don't need to hold down the control key. I've got GM selected. I'm just going to click Mazda and I'm going to click Honda and Ford. One more item about tables, and I'm going to go to the worksheet called chart. Just watch me do this, then we'll do this together. If I throw a chart in here, right here, I threw in a column chart. There it is. If I come in here and add something, the chart does not get updated because it is a range. So let me do an undo. So now let's do this together. convert this to a table, Control T, hit OK. Feel free to make your chart, but I'm going to fix this quarter one and quarter two. Let's go to the Home tab and maybe center those. That looks good. All right, so now let's make our chart. Insert tab. I'm going to put in a column chart, the default column chart. That looks great. I'm going to come down here below Butterfinger and type in KitKat. Hit the tab key. Notice the chart updated because it's a table. Let's make the numbers 25 and 25. Even if you came over to cell D1 and you added quarter three, it picks up quarter three in your chart. I love tables. Feel free to subscribe. Feel free to ring the bell. I appreciate your time. I hope you enjoyed this video on one of my favorite features, tables.